Hi friends, today we are going to discuss this chapter, flow through pipes in hydraulics and pneumatics. Now, all of us have seen a pipe. You know what is a pipe. Pipe is defined as a closed passage. Through which fluids flow under pressure . Pipe is a closed passage through which fluids flow under pressure. Now, pipes are classified into different types depending upon different considerations. Like, we have new pipes, old pipes, simple pipe, compound pipes. We have long pipes or short pipes. Like this, they can be classified on different basis: metallic and non-metallic, etc. They can be classified into different types. Now, what we are interested in study of pipes is, when a fluid flows through a pipe, there will be losses. So we are interested in finding out these losses. So we will discuss them today now. Losses in pipes. This is what we are interested. When a fluid flows through a pipe, there will be losses. Losses in pipes. Now, these losses are classified into two types. That is, major loss and minor loss. Major loss means bigger one. Minor means smaller one. So, the name itself says what it is. Major loss is the loss due to friction. Loss due to friction in a pipe. This is called as the major loss. And minor losses are loss at entrance, loss at exit. When it enters the pipe, there will be loss. When the liquid leaves the pipe, there will be loss. Loss at bends. Loss due to sudden expansion of pipe. And loss due to sudden contraction of pipe. These are called as minor losses. These are all minor losses. They are smaller in size and they are generally neglected. The only loss, major loss, is the loss due to friction. This is always considered. Generally it is considered. Those losses are neglected. Now, next is how to find the loss due to friction in a pipe. The loss effect due to friction in a pipe can be calculated, can be found out by using two formulae. Finding loss effect due to friction One of them is called the Darcy's formula, and the other formula is the Chazy's formula. First, we will take up the Darcy's formula. Now, the Darcy's formula can be written like this. HF is equal to 4FLV square by 2GD. This is so many meters. Or it can also be written as HF is equal to FLQ square divided by 3D to the power of 5 meters. These are the two formulae used to calculate, to find out the loss of it due to friction in pipes. These are the two formulae that are used. Either one of them can be used. They are called Darcy's formula. There is one more formula called the Chazy's formula, which will be discussed after this. Here, HF stands for head lost, pressure head lost due to friction, in meters of liquid. F is called the coefficient of friction, or it can also be called as Darcy's coefficient, Then L is length of pipe, in meters. V is velocity of flow through pipe in meters per second. G is acceleration due to gravity. In meters per second square, it is constant, you know, 9.81 meters per second square. D is diameter of pipe. In meters, in both the formulas, the notations are similar. Only one quantity changes here, that is Q. Q is discharge, quantity of liquid passing through the pipe, in cubic meters per second. So these are the nomenclature. These are the these letters stand for these quantities. Depending upon what we know and what we require to find out, we can use either this formula or that formula. Both are the same. When V is known or V is given or V is to be found out, we use this formula. If we know Q or Q is to be calculated, given other things, we use that formula. So these both are the same formula. One has velocity and the other has discharge. So these are the formulae for that. Next, the head loss due to friction in a pipe can also be found by Chazy's formula. One more formula is there called the Chazy's formula. That formula is the other formula is the Chazy's formula. This formula is V is equal to C root MI. This is the formula. C root MI. Here, V stands for velocity of flow through the pipe, in meters per second. C is a constant which is called the Chassis constant. Chassis constant. M is called hydraulic mean depth. Hydraulic mean depth in meters. The hydraulic mean depth is defined as this. M is a ratio of area of flow. Area of flow to wetted perimeter. Wetted perimeter, that is A by P. Generally, the pipes that we use are circular in section. So the area of flow, if D is the dia of the pipe, the area of flow will be pi d square by 4, and the wetted perimeter will be pi d. This pi gets cancelled, 1d gets cancelled, so this will be equal to d by 4 meters, where d is the dia of the pipe, d is the diameter of the pipe. Chassis constant. I is head lost due to friction in meters of liquid per meter length of pipe. Mathematically, it is HF divided by L, length of the pipe. L is the length of the pipe. Then if you know V, C, M, we can get I from this equation. And then if you multiply I by L, I into L gives you the head loss due to friction. These are the two formulae which are used to find the loss of head due to friction in pipes. Next, after this, we are supposed to calculate the power transmitted through pipeline. The power transmitted through a pipeline. Power transmitted through a pipeline. See, when a liquid flows through a pipe, what's happening? This liquid is having mass, and mass is getting displaced. Whenever mass gets displaced, we say mechanical work is done, and rate of doing mechanical work is known as power. So whenever a liquid flows through a pipe, power is transmitted through the pipe, and this power transmitted through the pipe can be calculated using the formula P is equal to W into Q into H minus HF, so many kilowatts. Now this P here is the power transmitted in kilowatts. W is specific weight of liquid flowing in unit kilonewton per cubic meter Q is discharge through the pipe discharge in cubic meters per second. The product of these two gives the mass of liquid displaced per second. H is available head, that is the head. It is called available head, that is the head, pressure head with which the liquid is entering the pipe in meters. And HF is head lost due to friction in meters. So this equation connects 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 quantities. If you know any 4 of them, the 5th quantity can be found out. So this is the formula for finding power transmitted through a pipeline. Next, efficiency of transmission. See here, we have a pipe. The liquid enters the pipe with a head of H meters and it is discharged from the pipe with a head of H minus HF. This is the head with at which it is discharged. This is the entry head. You know, efficiency is generally defined as a ratio of output to input. So here the output is H minus HF and the input is H. So this gives you the efficiency. To convert it into percentage, we multiply it by 100. This is always less than 1. If it is multiplied by 100, you get it in percentage. Next, condition for maximum power transmission. Optimum power transmission through a pipe. It can be mathematically proved. We can prove mathematically that a pipe transmits maximum power when HF, that is head loss due to friction, is 1/3 of the available head, that is H by 3, or the available head is 3 times the head loss due to friction. This is the condition for transmission of maximum power. Now, these are the formulae that you are supposed to remember in this particular chapter. If you remember this many formulae, any problem in this flow through pipes can be solved. Now, in this video, I have given you the theory portion of it, and in the next clip, I will be doing numericals in flow through pipes. You please subscribe and view and share my videos so that I can give you more quality videos. Thank you.